Welcome back to my project. It's Eric. This is my second LoRa project and is based on ESP32-LoRa. As you know, LoRa modules are capable of long-distance communication. Adjust the TX power output and use a larger antenna, so it seems that we can communicate up to 10 kilometers in an environment without obstacles. The two devices I'm using here are Android phones. The ESP32-based LoRa module is connected via USB serial. I made an app called LoRa Chat, which I think will be available for download from the Google Play Store this week. I'll add a link back to the video description when it's published. This app can send and receive simple messages using the LoRa module. The key to this project is that it can be used offline. The point is that communication between two devices is possible without cellular, Wi-Fi, or Bluetooth. So, I was able to make it possible to communicate with two devices anywhere. Usually, using a LoRa module, one side includes a sensor, and the other side is often used for receiving this data only. But, if we use these mobile applications, there may be more places where we can take advantage of them. Let's take a look at what we need to do the same thing. Here is the ESP32-LoRa device I'm using. This is a product made by LoRa and based on the ESP32. Since it is being used in the United States, I must use the frequency, 915 MHz. The reason I initially chose this device was because it had a battery holder that could be used with 18650 batteries. I connected several sensors to this device from a remote location and transferred the information collected from the sensors to another connected LoRa device. Since there was no power source, it had to be operated with batteries, and it could be operated for a very long time with the 18650 battery. This is the source code to connect with LoRa Chat application. We all have different types of microcontrollers and LoRa modules. So, we need to modify this source code for our hardware. If it isn't, it doesn't work. Also, you can find this source code in the below video description. This program communicates with the Android device through serial. So, it is basically sending and receiving serial data from the Android application to the ESP32. For example, if you send chatting data from mobile, this data is sent as serial data. In order to distinguish which message it is, the opcode is appended to the data. This opcode tells the ESP32 what to do. If an opcode starting with 2 is entered, this is a request to update the GPS information. First, it transmits my GPS information to the mobile, and it requests and fetches GPS information from the connected device. This source code allows you to send and receive data. So, there is no distinction between the receiving side and the sending side. As you can see, the length of the code is not long. Its role is simply to send and receive data and control everything from the mobile app. This is a matrix effect, just for fun. Just click on this icon to jump right in. The first thing to do is connect the device and open the serial port. Tap the icon at the top right of the screen to see the menu. You can see available serials here. If nothing appears here even after connecting the device, there is a possibility that the USB serial chip is not supported. The ESP32 I'm using uses Silicon Labs UART chip. Let's connect by pressing the connect button. Now that the device is connected, you can start chatting. Let's try sending a message to another device. The message is being sent. And the message transmission was confirmed. I think this part is the heart of this app. This is because it's an important feature to know if the data transmitted through LoRa has really been confirmed by the other party. Transmitting via LoRa is not 100% guaranteed. Therefore, it's important to be able to check through these functions. The sender's name is James. This is the default name and you can change it to any name you like. I'll show you how to change it. You can change your name here by clicking on my icon. Still changed avatars are not updated on the other side. Now let's send the message again. Did you see the right one? The initials of my name have changed from J to E. You can use it like a messenger app we normally use. But there are downsides. It's just that you can't send and receive messages at the same time. The message sent by the other side cannot be received until the task is finished on one side. It can be said that it works like a half duplex. On this screen, you can receive and view the GPS information of the NE06M of both devices. This data is also transmitted via LoRa. Also, if the battery is connected, the current battery information is displayed. I'm currently indoors, so I'm having trouble getting a GPS signal. In this project, I configured a system that can transmit short text using an Android phone and an ESP32-based LoRa module. Based on this, if several functions are added, it will be useful. Also, one thing I want to try is a system that communicates with two or more LoRa modules. I'd like to communicate with multiple Androids using LoRa on a tablet with a large screen. This will definitely be fun. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, see you on the next project.